This is a woman I heard through a feature at Carpo. She was on a double bill with someone I really liked. And she did 35 minutes worth of limericks.
Oh, God.
Broken down by category. She would get up and she would say, here are three limericks about anger. And then she would do three limericks while shuffling to the music of Tito Puente.
Isn't that illegal?
Yeah.
No, but it's... Well, no, only because nobody told Giuliani about it. Okay, let me see. I'm sure there's some stuff in here I have not read here yet. Yeah, here's sort of an interesting little piece for anyone who knows me. I was doing my normal stream of consciousness thing and it started to rhyme. And I found that if you expect something to rhyme, it will. It's sort of like the way Ouija boards work. This is called falling. My feet stay on the ground. My feet flay the round ground, bound for sound deductions. The line of sight wounds me at a fitting time. I hide and rhyme and scrabble on the pavement for sheddings of inspiration in the semi-dark. In the park where dogs clack in mind and memory, and I hide from what I want to see. Lectured from the trombone skies, I writhe under the press of illness and the growling streets. Hey, what's under those sheets? Love and hate in equal measure, rumpled or pointed, what's your pleasure? I take off what I take up, my heart begins to wake up, and I listen for the sound of my orphan children coming round, couched in the hand of another, a brilliant but unlikely mother, moving shadows right and flit, and having writ they never sit, blind to my mind, they avoid my newly feeble grasp, biting like the asp of an East End jewel box I once filled. But now the hunter of words is killed and stuffed and mounted on the bragging wall. Back to the primitive, to the beat that is all and all and all and ill and ailing. In a vacuum, nobody can hear me wailing. I rip my trip to stipulate the fate I ate while dribbling over the grate. The horse grinds to a stop. It's metal, after all. I fall. I fall. I ram my head into the light and struggle to land safely while it still be night, because when the air changes, my mind rearranges, and I can't get out of the bed I'm not in, and I can't waver, and I can't sin. My throat closes, the hole knits up, I sits up and gallops through the exit, trying to squeeze in where I don't rightly fit, and this mutant scream leaks out through my pen, and I turn again, I turn again, I return again, I burn again. And I call this Dumpster Days because I wrote it while leaning on an actual dumpster. It's the one outside 13. A smile stuck in amber, sparkling, spanking, delighted to be anywhere under the round ground, grimace over a piece, stylish, but not in the mode of survival. Sheer and shorn, torn open to reveal teeth frozen by hard water, plop, plop onto the floor of enduring misery. Underground, the world becomes a shadow and shapes itself into a turd unheard of in the atmosphere, sucked up from the carpet into a clump of trash, ash, agony, packaged in green paper and summarily discarded. A smile rests on a shelf, waiting to be undersold on a flat land in the middle of a round horizon. The floor of earth ripples under the smile, groans at the invasion of 10 steaks me to a good meal and a ride downtown in the dry darkness of my performance. Wrinkled, rippled, stuck in brine and found in a ditch, abandoned by the very, very people steepled under my fingers until I grope for the wall and fall over end, zoning out as your lips move, dragging down the intelligence of thought and time, groping, grasping, griping, green, you were there and back off until I reach the ledge and pace into the pittance of days spent stringing together the elements of confession, contusion, strike up and down while the millinery runs out and nakedness becomes the order of the day's end on a page where beige sells at a premium price. This agony squats in the middle of an hour and hours and iron crosses the crisis of race to the bottom and out the sides, flushing cardboard through the streets after a rain of terror and a hail of dregs. knocking down the average, flattening the spring so that no response becomes normal. Schooled in the niceties of handling trash, I transmigrate into a dingy fallopian area, egging on the density of despair. I seek shelter in gloves, but they become works of art and expose me to the world of whirls and girls who dance backward and forward over a nipple of steel, ready to erupt in steam and grease, pandering, pondering, missing all the hands groping in superior sentience that bores to the root of a conundrum and finds me flat underneath the floor of acceptance. Flinch from me in tenderness. Put your thumb way down here and appreciate what I have never shrunk from lending you. Hand over hand, end over end, top over bottom, topple over and bottom out underneath the plastic skirt. Is a captive light that sheds stars on your hand until your every gesture blinds me. I stand up foolishly until a chair knocks me down in emptiness and fear of cheers. I surround myself with your loneliness like armor, appropriating the type of talk that bosoms me to the ground of heaven, digging up layers of cloud and throwing the pieces everywhere, carelessly reaching the hard rock, finally ramming, jamming, joining, jousting. I fall off my horse sideways and get no further than I would have. I take your measure, you skirt the issuance of script readily molded to buy me entrance to the lobby where noise sheds wisdom, and I still can't see the point except to be there always, just in case.